What is going on, boys and girls, he's and she's, days and it's. It's your boy Keegan, back with another banger. Today, I'm going to be going into my top five all-time greatest scorers in the NBA. Now, I'm going to give you guys a little secret. It's not just five people. In my opinion, there's a tie for fifth place, so there's going to be six players on this top five all-time list. And we're going to go ahead and kick it right off. Coming in at number five, the greatest probably ball handle besides maybe Allen Iverson. I don't know. I still think that it's a little more smooth than Iverson. Kyrie Irving. Uncle Drew, what makes Kyrie Irving so high on this list, so high in, you know, all time on scoring, is he is so silky and smooth. The way that he can get to any spot with either hand finished so well, it's just incredible. The greatest ball handle of all time, possibly. And then not only is he going to cut you wide open and get wherever he wants and the greatest finisher in the game right now, but he's gonna shoot on your head as well. The guy is deadly from three. The only thing that I wish Kyrie would do more is work harder off ball, but he's a ball dominant guard and he is an absolute highlight reel to watch. It's effective. He's number five on our all-time scoring. Coming in tied for number five, we have, by far, no argument, the greatest shooter the world has ever seen. Now, Steph Curry and Kyrie Irving, to me, at this moment, as pure offensive scorers, not as point guards, not as shooting guards, just as offensive players, to me, I slightly take Steph over Kyrie, maybe, but I had to battle, so they're tied for fifth on this list. They're both top five all-time scorers to me. When you break down Steph Curry, it's not just that he is the greatest shooter of all time by a mile. Back in the day, if you came down the floor and shot a three on a fast break, you're benched. Whether you're college, NBA, high school, it didn't matter. Rec leagues, you're going to the bench if you shoot from three on a fast break. You're not supposed to do it. So the fact that Steph Curry was so lethal from behind the arc, NBA range, that he changed the entire game and made it acceptable for players at all levels to shoot threes on fast breaks, is just incredible. Now, what makes him top five all time is the fact that just his shooting alone makes him top 10 all time scoring. He's a better shooter than Ray Allen. His finishing is on par with somebody almost like Kyrie Irving. He's one of the best finishers at 6'2", 6'3" tops. We will never see another off ball shooting, finishing, effortlessly yo-yoing the rock type player like Steph Curry ever again. We just won't ever see it again. I don't think we'll ever see a shooter his caliber again. I think he's a once-in-a-lifetime talent from shooting, and he's a generational scoring talent. Very underrated on defense as well. And yeah, if I had to choose out of him and Kyrie, I'm taking Steph. Steph can lead me to titles, and Steph is truly unstoppable because of the offense off the ball. That's what he has over Kyrie. He works so hard off the ball. And if you want to try to stop him from facilitating, that's fine. We'll bring in another point guard and I'll just play the two and work off ball. Or Draymond can play the point forward. I'll play off ball. Klay Thompson gets hot. I'll play off ball. And he's not a spot up. He can spot up with the greatest. He can shoot on the move with the greatest. He can create his own shots. He is the greatest at creating his own shots. From behind the arc, he's one of the greatest finishers of all time. Steph Curry coming in at number five. Probably will end up higher on this list if he keeps going and winning more championships. Coming in at number four, we got, and this is debatable. This guy could have been number five on your list, and Steph Curry or Kyrie possibly could have been over him. Steph Curry could possibly be over him. I don't see Kyrie being over him. We have the greatest small guard, scoring guard ever, Allen Iverson, the problem. Now, when Iverson was young, a lot of people don't know, Iverson has a whole dunk reel. Just uber athleticism, just going up, put back dunks off of missed free throws, dunking on people's heads. He was an absolute beast off the bounce, younger in his career. And then, in his day, we had never seen a handle like his. And what he would do is he would finish around the rim over Shaq, over Dikembe Mutombo, over Marcus Camby, over the greatest defenders. He played the Lakers, The Lakers dynasty, he played them by himself and put up, I think, 50 or something on Kobe. Kobe, one of the greatest defenders of all time. Iverson averaged like 28 or 30 on Kobe. The duels between Iverson and Kobe used to be so epic. And the fact that a guy 6 foot or 5 foot 11 was dueling with Kobe Bryant says enough. But it was his finishing around the rim. It was his ball handle, his mid-range game. And he was just probably, you know, pound for pound, the greatest shot creator we've ever seen around that mid-range, short-range type area. And yeah, probably the greatest crossover the game's ever seen as well. Coming in at number four, we got my boy, Allen Iverson. Coming in at number three, we have... A lot of people aren't going to like this, but I have Kobe Bryant at number three. A lot of people will say that he's the greatest scorer of all time. And I will counter that with Jordan did it more effortlessly. Jordan was more efficient. Jordan got his team involved a little bit more. Phil Jackson was able to get Michael Jordan to do it within the rhythm of the team more. So he was able to score just as good as Kobe, but more efficiently and with less effort. Kobe's a Michael Jordan clone. And anytime you're the second one to do it, you're just, you know, we've seen that, you know, but it was still so lethal that he's top three scoring all time. Now, if you needed somebody to go get you a bucket, you know Kobe's going to go try to do it. But me personally, there's two people that I would prefer efficient-wise that are just as good, if not better, at getting buckets. And that's who I would take. And who that is at number two, the 7-foot shooting guard, basically, Kevin Durant. Guys, Kevin Durant has been such a disappointment. Kobe Bryant said that he left the league not knowing how to stop him. Now, that's the only player Kobe Bryant has ever said he's had a problem with. Okay? Nobody else has ever got that type of love from Kobe Bryant. You're talking about a guy 7 foot with like a 7'4 wingspan, maybe more, that's pulling up from logo whenever he wants to, taking shots off the dribble whenever he wants to, 7 foot so he can stand and dunk on anything, slithery finisher, slim reaper, gracious around the rim, a 7-footer that moves like a shooting guard, guys. I mean, I don't know what else to say. And, you know, we're not talking about defense right now, but when I do my all-time player list or my all-time defender list, this guy's going to be up there on that too. Just imagine if Dirk Nowitzki had a shooting guard's ball handle and was a more ferocious finisher. And that's what you get with KD, with Kevin Durant. There's nothing else to say. He's borderline the greatest scorer of all time. And you guys know who's coming in at number one. In my opinion, it's a no-brainer. The GOAT himself, Michael Jordan Jordan. There are times I want to say LeBron James is better than Jordan. There are times I want to say Kobe might have been better than Jordan. There are times I want to say, oh, Kevin Durant's the greatest scorer I've ever seen. Steph Curry is the greatest scorer I've ever seen. And then I go watch these highlights. And when you watch the high-definition highlights, the way that he was manipulating defenders, hanging in the air, and his style, I mean, just his style, the cradling, the hanging, it was so effortless and easy. They called him Black Jesus. His mid-range game is as deadly as it'll ever come. What made him the greatest scorer was the fact that he stretched his game out to the three-point line. And when he gets downhill, guys, good luck. When Michael Jordan came into the league, he was dribbling through everybody. They were full court pressing this kid, and he was just dribbling through everybody. He had no jump shot. Anthony Edwards. He looked a lot like Anthony Edwards. You're talking about a two guard with a 40-something inch vertical, the deadliest mid-range game we've ever seen. back to the basket game crazy. ISO, greatest ISO scorer ever. Arguably Durant's there. It's out of him and Durant. Ball handle, worked on it, left to right, doesn't matter. Finish, hang in the air, style, finesse, force, strength. Guys, Michael Jordan is the greatest. And it's because, first, he's the greatest scorer, and he's arguably the greatest defender. That's my top five for you guys. Do me a favor, like, share, subscribe. I'm trying to blow this channel up, and you mother been. So subscribe, like, share. It's your boy Keegan. I'll see you guys in the next one.